Okay, before we start, we are happy to share with everyone here that Founders Diary is supported by several amazing partners. And before we jump into the session, let's get to know a little bit better about our partners. So the first one we have Amazon Web Service. I guess everyone here knows about AWS already. Second one we have Uptown Service Office. They are located in Plaza Mutiara, Mega Kuningan. They provide business solution for corporate and individual who needs private office, co-working space, meeting rooms, event space, and virtual office. And we are also supported by Payroll Boss, which is a cloud-based human resources information system, a software or apps that simplified all HR administrative tasks. And then we are also supported by MICTI, or it's an Indonesia Digital Creative Industry Community. They are a nonprofit organization function as a gathering place for all people who pay attention to the development of digital creative industries in Indonesia. MICTI was established on December 2008. We are also supported by Amicom Business Park. So they are a startup incubator in Yogyakarta. So we are supported by Amicom Business Park, which is a startup incubator in Jogja. And we are also supported by Cakap, so that we are currently live at Cakap application as well. They are an online learning platform and application that supported two-way interaction. And we are also supported by mTarget, which is the number one marketing automation tool in Indonesia. We help business to become more personal with their customers, from gathering lead generation to customer retention. It can be completed on a simple and easy to use mTarget platform. So after the event, we normally send out a thank you email to all participants, and mTarget is supporting us on that side. Okay, that are all the partners for today. Let's check up if the live streaming is back on. Okay, while we wait, some moderators and all the speakers are here already. If you want to start to turn on the video and unmute yourself, that's okay too.
Okay, thank you, Natasha. Hi, welcome everyone. This is our 16th episode where we'll be talking about business as unusual. Usually we say that business as usual, but because of this COVID, we're talking about business as unusual. It's how COVID-19 could change the future of work. For those of you who are new to our series, the reason why we have this series is because we understand that building a company can be a lonely journey. While there are definitely joys of entrepreneurship, there are also significant challenges. In our Founders Diary series, we ask founders about what their days look like and reflect on what they discovered during the process. So today I'm going to moderate this with my twin brother, Aditya Dharma. We're the founders of Prasetya Dharma. We founded the company back in 2008. It started off as a construction for telecommunication industry, and since 2013 we started investment in many tech companies in Indonesia, Singapore, and US. So today we have two amazing speakers. The first one is Emerson Lin, co-founder of GigaCover. GigaCover delivers flexible and affordable essential insurance, healthcare, and cash services to the future of work. And the second speaker is Sunny Saurabh, co-founder and CEO at Interviewer.ai. Interviewer.ai is a recruitment optimization tool for businesses. It helps you shortlist top quality candidates from hundreds of applications in minutes. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, Emerson. Thank you, Sunny, for joining us today. I will let you, each of you, introduce yourself. Emerson, please go ahead and introduce yourself and about GigaCover with your own words.
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much, Arya and RD, for hosting this series. I keep telling everybody this, you know, I'm here stuck in Singapore, but I would very much like to be over there in Jakarta, in the trenches of what's happening over there. So I was told that I could share my screen. So let me try to do that. So I just have, you know, my company website to, yeah, so a quick introduction about GigaCover. So I'm one of the founders, and we started this company about 3.5 years ago. And we started it in Singapore, and we only just launched in Jakarta earlier this year. right? So I'm very excited for our company to have expanded over into Indonesia. So ever since we started the company, I think we noticed two big trends, right? So one trend is that there's a lot of activity, a lot of migration of employment to self-employment. And to me, you know, gig workers, self-employed individuals, freelancers, this is the future of work, right? People are gravitating towards, you know, freedom, towards flexibility, towards multiple streams of income. And we also noticed another trend, which was in order to serve this new economy, this new workforce, many incumbents, so banks and insurers, were very willing to partner with startups like us in order to bring new products and services to this, you know, very big and growing trend. Yeah. So what we do is simple. We want to make sure there is economic and financial stability and security for these future workers, right? They don't have access to affordable and suitable, you know, insurance, healthcare, and cash services. And I know many people are attacking this problem, but we are attacking it, and we are working through platforms. We have a B2B2C strategy going through platforms like Lalamove, Foodpanda, Gojek, you know, Ranguru, Lalali. Some of those are our clients. Some we are trying, you know, some of them we are trying to work with. But yeah, that's our model. That's how we plan to reach the workers and how we plan to deliver our services. So if you can see from this quick landing page, right, we offer, you know, advance. This is an advance on, you know, a worker's earnings or salary with a platform. We also offer insurance products. This can be hospital cash, critical illness, personal accident, gadget insurance, dengue insurance. And we also offer access to healthcare, right? So we have partners for all three of these services. And we can offer access to, you know, teleconsultations, rapid tests, swab tests, you know, pharmaceutical drugs and medicines. Right. So by being, you know, sort of the mega group, the mega corporasi for all these workers, you know, we hope to bring and deliver these benefits to them. And as, you know, the topic of today, the future of work, business as unusual, right? You know, we are also finding that it's going to be the unusual and creative ways to deliver these products and services that are going to work. Okay. Thank you very much. I'm going to stop sharing my screen.
Okay. Thank you, Emerson. Thank you for the short introduction. Okay. Sunny, how about you? Is there anything that you want to share as well? Or just
I'm not sure. Yourself? Yeah, I'll just probably talk for my city area after almost a year. So I'm Sunny Saurabh. I've been working for startups like Google, LinkedIn, MySpace for about 15 odd years before I started to start my own journey. Fantastic times. And with Interview.ai, we're trying to solve a very basic problem. You know, resumes don't reflect the real skills required for the modern workforce. You know, skills like communication, interpersonal skills, motivation. Why are they trying to join your company? You don't know any of those. And yet, you know, if you look at Indonesia, you'd have companies like Tokopedia, Gojek, you'd have millions of resumes being sent every year, right? And you can't interview everybody. You can't. With human, it will take you 100 years to interview every single candidate. And that's why we created interviewer.ai. And our vision is to interview everyone, every single candidate, so that we can extract the skills, score them, so that hiring managers can make a very, very informed decision. So that's what we are working on.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Sunny. Okay, so let's just jump into the questions that we already prepared. The first one is, how do you think the pandemic has changed the future of work? Since your face is on the front of my screen, let's start with Sunny.
Sure. So, I mean, it has changed drastically to the future of work. I'll just list down three things. The first is office occupancy. So going forward, after COVID, the office occupancy will come down to about 35% of the actual workforce. You would have rotating staff. People would be working from home. People will be working, you know, from offices when they need to collaborate, they need to strategize. They need to whiteboard things, but it's not going to remain the same. So I don't know what implication it has for commercial real estate, but I think it has a huge implication for the residential real estate, because you need to have in a home now a small space where you can call it an office, right? So there's an opportunity there. Secondly, business travel. If you look at global business travel, 80% of it was for business travelers all the time. Now, people have realized that you can actually sell from home. You don't really need to visit London, Paris, Singapore. You can do work it on a Zoom call or on a Kiskus call, for example, right? So after this COVID thing, pandemic, after the vaccine is created, I don't think you'd have as many business travel as used to be. And thirdly, hiring. Hiring was always face-to-face, right? In Indonesia, in Singapore, in Asia generally, we rely on our gut instinct and feel and how you know, the vibe you get when you meet in person. That's gone. So it's all through a short video chat. You have to make hiring decisions. And that's where we at interview.ai come in.
When you're talking about the, you actually can sell without actually meeting the customer. Is that what you're facing right now?
So is that what we are facing?
Is that what you're experiencing right now? Like, it's a positive sign, right? That you can actually close more deals without actually meeting the customer.
Absolutely. So we're not just seeing deals, but also, so I was stuck in Germany for 4 months. I just made it a month ago. And a lot of interactions were happening on a call, on a Zoom call. I met two investors who made investment decisions by not meeting in person. We have had sales relationships in London. We sold our first customer in Barcelona in 5 days. That was during COVID, never met them in person. So this is the future. So I think the geographical boundaries will disappear. You can have sales team in a variety of different places where it's more economical, where you have the right talent, and they can serve any part of the globe. That's what I see.
I see. That's interesting from your experience as well. How about you, Emerson? How has it changed for the future of work, according to your view?
You know, what Sunny said makes a lot of sense. And I think the way to summarize maybe a bit is just, you know, digital transformation, right? Every business has just accelerated their ability to adopt digital solutions. Anything from just having video conferencing to better chat solutions, to just more collaboration online and, you know, across countries or geographies without meeting in person. And this is sort of the starting point for all the other repercussions, right? This has driven, you know, the need for different sets of workforces. So there's been a lot of retrenchment, but yet, you know, they will rehire on a more part-time or contingent informal basis. They are more open to part-time, you know, employees going part-time, right? So only wanting to work, you know, half a day, and that just accommodates more people who want, you know, to have time for their families or other businesses. And automation, right? This is also going to change a lot of the work that's being done that maybe is more labor intensive now has a lot of safety concerns, because these labor intensive work tend to also be more dense, right, and higher risk of spread of whatever it is. So yeah, automating that, replacing that with robots, right? That's also part of the future of work, more automation. And similarly, digital transformation has also driven, unfortunately, you know, a lot more retrenchment, because certain jobs are being displaced and more people are being forced into, you know, willingly or unwillingly into self-employment. But the good news is, at the same time, demand is opening up elsewhere. Demand is opening up in delivery, in security, in cleaning, right? So I think we're seeing just a good shift in the future of work from, you know, older industries and newer industries, just different models of work. More automation, more digital transformation, and it's, yeah, that's what I see. That's what I see, you know, sort of the common theme across all businesses and corporates.
Okay. Thank you, Emerson. So I think continuing to the next question, how does the pandemic impact your internal company? What has changed in terms of working in the new normal way? Just continue with you, Emerson. I mean, anything new in terms of working from home or still working from home,